YouTube, it's MasterAquatics, and I'm bringing you guys
another video.
In this video, I just want to talk about breeding angelfish and the best setup for breeding angelfish. It's very simple. You only need three things. That's right, three things. 75-gallon tank and above, 29-gallon tank, 20-gallon tank, and I will tell you what each of those are for. 75-gallon tanks and up, this is where you're going to get your pair, okay? If you're not planning on buying a pair and you're trying to naturally get a pair out of a group of angelfish, you're going to want to put about eight or more angelfish in your big aquarium. You want to start off with maybe juvenile or medium-sized angelfish. You don't want to get them too big. When they're too big, they're not really good for breeding. Their spawn rates won't be so great. So you want to get some fresh young angelfish with a group of eight or more, and you want to breed them. What type of angelfish should you breed? I actually have a video on that. I'll post a link down in the description, but you can breed any type of angelfish. Any angelfish will sell as long as they look good. What makes an angelfish look good? If they have nice finnage, nice patterns, nice color, they can be sold easily to a local fish store, or you can sell them online to eBay or Aquabid. You can sell them on Craigslist. There's lots of people out there that are just getting into the hobby that are willing to buy some nice looking angelfish. You want to create some angelfish that have some long fins that are straight, that are not too curvy. The longer the fins, the better. Take this one for example. This one is still a decent angelfish because of his size, but his fins are not that great. They're kind of short and stubby. You want to go for something like that. Long fins. You don't need to have decorations in your tank to breed angelfish or to get a pair. I have decorations in my tank because that's what I prefer. It's my preference. If you really want to breed angelfish hardcore, I recommend a bare bottom tank for all your tanks. It's easier to clean, easier to maintain, easier to manage, and it'll benefit you in the long run. Less water changes, cleaner water. It's just all around better for your aquarium. But if you don't like bare bottom tanks, you can decorate your big tank, but you don't want to decorate your smaller tanks like your 29-gallon tank and your 20-gallon tank. You don't want to decorate those. Those you want to keep bare bottom. So like I said, you can decorate these. You can put some plants in there. Angelfish love heavily planted tanks. So if you plan on decorating this tank, I suggest researching what type of plants to put in there and what type of substrate. I do have a few videos on what type of plants you can use and what substrate. I also have a video on setting up this tank. I'll link that down in the description. Make sure to check that out. The reason why you want a planted tank or a heavily planted tank is because angelfish love to breed on plants such as anubias leaves, such as these right here. They also love to hide if they need to. So you want to give them some good hiding places because angelfish, they can be aggressive at times, especially when they get older and when they're breeding. So you want to prevent aggression by breaking line of sight. And to do that, you want to have like plants just growing in certain areas where angelfish can't see other angelfish from across the tank. It'll definitely help them. I don't have that currently in my tank because this is a new tank. The plants haven't fully grown yet. It will take time for the plants to grow, but eventually it'll get to where I need it to be. For the 29-gallon tank, That's gonna be your pair tank. That's where you're gonna keep your pair. This is where your angelfish pair is going to do all the work for you. You can find this on eBay. I got mine on eBay. Just go to www.ebay.com, search angelfish breeding slate, and it'll be the first thing to pop up. It costs about $7. Now, once you get your group of angelfish, it'll take about 6 to 10 months before you get a pair. When you get a pair, you want to move the pair into their own tank. That's where the 29-gallon tank comes in play. You put them in their own tank. You want them to have a sponge filter. And this tank, you do want to keep it bare bottom. Reason being is if you decide to have your pair raise your fry, then you want to have it bare bottom so the fry don't get stuck in between the rocks and the substrate and the gravel. They'll die. Long story short. Also, you can keep a hang on the back filter there. Just make sure you turn it off whenever they start laying eggs and start spawning for you, because the hang on the back filter could kill your baby fish and you don't want that to happen. And so sponge filter, slate, hang on the back filter, bare bottom, 29-gallon tank, pair of angelfish. That's all you need in 29-gallon tank. Now for the 20-gallon tank, this is where you're going to keep your babies. Now, if you do decide to hatch your angelfish eggs on your own and take care of them yourself instead of letting the parents do all the work for you, which in most cases they won't. In most cases, they will eat the eggs and they will eat their babies, but every now and then you'll get a pair that will not eat their babies and they will take care of them. I've had a pair like that, but it's not too often that you get a pair like that. So that's where you get your 20-gallon tank, and in this tank, you just want sponge filters in here. You don't want hang on the back filter. Maybe you want a anubias plant in there. This will definitely help you. Angelfish love plants, like I mentioned earlier. And I do have an auto feeder here. I just installed it. I'm not sure if this works, but a lot of people say it does work. What this does is this takes out all the work and hatching brine shrimp on a daily basis and getting up, you know, before work or, you know, whatever, and feeding these guys. This will actually feed the babies for you. All you have to do is just replace the eggs and the baby brine shrimp every now and then. I just set it up today, so I don't know if it actually works, but I will update you guys on this. But I heard a lot of good things about it. It's about $20. Link is in the description if you're interested in this. These are my baby angelfish. This came from my Philippine blue angelfish pair. And these guys are about a week and a half old, and they're doing great. They're already getting big. There's also a mixed batch in here, so you have a little bit of smaller ones in here as well, such as that one. It's so small I can't even focus. That's how small it is. But compare that one to this one, and you can see that, you know, they're totally different sizes. So that's pretty much the basics. It's pretty much, you know, once you have your three tanks and you have your pair, it's pretty much just a waiting game after that. So that's pretty much it. You just need those three tanks and make sure that they're up and running. Make sure that your 29-gallon tank is bare bottom. Make sure that your 20-gallon tank is bare bottom. And make sure you also research, you know, how to take care of these guys. I have lots of videos and lots of personal experience on raising angelfish. So if you need help, you can check out some of the links in the description that will help you in raising these guys. Hopefully I've answered all the questions regarding taking care of baby angelfish. Once you have your three tanks, it's just a waiting game. You gotta wait about 6 to 10 months until your group of angelfish pair up and they'll start laying eggs for you. Even then, the work doesn't stop there. You know, you'll have to learn how to take care of them, learn how to care for the eggs, make sure that you feed them on time, make sure that you clean out their water. Another piece of advice that I can give you guys is that if you plan on doing this, make sure that you're willing to change out the water of your aquarium at least once a week. At least once a week, and do like a big water change, like maybe a 75% water change, because that will get your angelfish in the mood for spawning. Nothing gets angelfish wanting to breed faster than a water change and also a serving of bloodworms. Bloodworms will definitely get your fish in the mood, so keep that in mind. Also, feeding them flakes about twice a day, that will actually help them too. Just make sure that they feel comfortable, make sure that they feel secure. Also, feed them a varied diet. If you don't know what angelfish eat, they eat, you know, a lot of different things. Flakes, bloodworms, mysis, shrimp. You can even feed them algae wafers. You can feed them all kinds of stuff. They'll pretty much eat anything that fits into their mouth. The only thing from personal experience that they won't eat is seaweed or anything that's green. I know that San Francisco Bay Brand, they have like frozen foods, and one of them is like this green vegetable type product. I can't remember the name of it. I'll put it up on the screen right here. They won't go for that, so don't try to feed your angelfish that. At least my angelfish won't eat it. So that's pretty much it. Like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care, and bye-bye.
Thank you, young God, for the blessing, ayy.